Oh, good evening, everybody. Today we are playing just a short stream of Decisive Campaigns, Ardennes Offensive. And yeah, let's check where did we leave off last time in our playthrough. We were somewhere around here in the center of the line. It's the 116th Panzer Division, which fought a couple of battles here, engaged with the enemy armor. We managed to break their infantry, and their tanks have withdrawn. Here, our push towards Saint Vith is progressing quite nicely. We have Hetzers and Stugs and Pioneers racing from the southern side. In today's stream, we are focusing on closing the distance to Saint Vith from the northern side. In addition, we will be seeking to destroy these enemy units that have been surrounded here and are more or less a nuisance to us right now. They just have a very good readiness score, but they are inexperienced, so maybe destroying the easiest ones first that are exposed in the open ground. And I did some research on that battle that we waged last turn. So, yeah, basically. So I'm referring to this tank battle that we engaged with the 70th Tank Battalion in these heavy forests. I personally, I had an inkling that it's going to be a tank unit in those forests. But of course the game, when it was calculating its odds, had no way of really knowing what is in there. So that's why we saw that kind of odds that were like 9 to 1 favorable for us. Whereas in reality, attacking this kind of force with infantry that have only a couple of Panzerschrecks, even though we had these Pakkans, but because their visibility is so bad in these forests, so they can't get a clear shot, so their effectiveness wasn't that great. Same goes with the Hetzers. So it was really an uneven battle. And yeah, I think I learned my lesson regarding that you should get a better knowledge for the game, that it can calculate the combat odds better. Or now you just know that basic infantry against tanks is a bad idea. And even if you have anti-tank equipment, it might not work out if the enemy is not in the open fields. So yeah, I did I booted to the latest save and did a couple of tests with their artillery impacts when enemy is a tank unit in heavy woods. Surprise, surprise, it doesn't really have any effect. So soft targets are good targets for artillery, and if the enemy is covered in heavy forests or in heavily urban areas, it doesn't really matter. So artillery should be used only against targets that are without any natural cover or are lightly covered. I guess that's my main lesson. lesson learned from that attack. But yes, let's jump right into this. Clearing out these pockets. I'm just checking these. Okay, this is the integrity score. I think there were some tweaks in the very latest patch. I don't have that yet installed because I have... these are not official ones, these are still beta phase patches. But there will be some updates regarding this integrity value. That this is the most crucial for a unit to stay on the map, basically. If the integrity goes too much below 20%, yeah, it can really stop existing as a fighting unit. I'm not sure what happens to those units after. Will they be able to be retrieved to the reinforcements pool, or do they just disappear? Are they deserting, so to say? But in the latest patch, the beta patch, you will also see some kind of table of equipment associated with this integrity score. So I think that's going to be helpful in the future, but I don't have that yet installed, so I can't see. There were some updates in this 0.07 patch that I have right now. It's more about this, more detailed information about the weight and carry requirements of units. For instance, this leg infantry, it doesn't have any motorized equipment, whereas these pioneers, we can look at the value. Sorry, let me just activate Epic Pen tool. We can look at these weight and carry stats. So we have the weight of units moving on foot, which is 62. Then we have the carrying capacity, I guess. We have 12 wheel, 69 tracked, wheel 4 times 4. We have 4 of those, which gives us an 85. Then there is the manpower, which is the amount of men in the unit, which is 556. And apparently these are summed together, these carry statistics here. 80, 345, 12, 437. This is together 437. And I guess it calculates a proportion of this 556. Or is this... Anyways, it has these two numbers highlighted, and then it says the motorization chance is 17% in total. Yeah, is this just a proportion of this 85 of this that needs to be carried, I guess? Or what these the carry is, that's what it can carry, I think. This 437 and 556, I think those are the crucial numbers, not the 85 necessarily. Or is that like, yeah, I'm not completely sure about this, but I just wanted to let you know that it has been a bit improved. So this is more detailed as it used to be. Uh, Then we have unit details, that's about supply, fuel status, upkeep required in supply source, so on, so on, so on. There's the replacement information, missing 60 engineers or half trucks requested. I guess those are like how much it has requested from the HQ trucks. It's missing 8, it has requested 3. And do I have to close this? Oh yeah, it's like so big that it actually goes a little bit over. So you have to hide this. Or you can just close it like that. But it's not scrollable, this right hand bar, apparently. But that doesn't matter, you can just always just hide one of these levels, so... But yeah, this is something that we have to start playing with, actually. It is the supply efficiency, replacement efficiency. So we have the priority setting here. Units receive replacements before all non-priority units. Okay, if strength drops below 100%. So this is a way of us making sure that the replacements go to units that are doing offensive operations or places where we basically need reinforcements. So I need to have to start tweaking these values actually. I think these are intercept, int, retreat. I think it can be modified if I click this. What if I do now this? Yeah. The retreat changed to 100% because I put it to last man standing. And now it should be back to 50%. Yeah. So this, what you click here on next to the unit card, toggles those values that are here in the retreat. And the intercept, well, this unit doesn't have any ranged weapons, so this doesn't matter, this setting for the interception. If it would have mortars or something, then it could intercept. Yeah. Okay, but those were just a couple of things that I felt like I wanted to show you. And I think also something that is going to be important for us at some point when our Panzers go deep into the enemy lines, we will have to move the leg infantry there some one way or another. They can't just be marching there, so we need those trucks. So we have to use transport mode. And I guess then we will just learn how to use it. But yeah, now I'm going to attack these American units. Let's do some probing. This unit rather here, this here. I think this can do the probe. We have 67 recon. They have still 2 mortars left. I can do one more barrage. These don't really have... If you look at this unit, it has a red value here. Supply attack modifier, it's minus 58. So it can't really perform a maximal attack with the amount of supplies it carries. But yeah, it's not actually calculated here in the modifiers. I guess it just is modified in how many rounds of combat it can perform. But that's okay. I think I should have actually used this unit to recon. to the probing, and this could have still attacked from the high ground. Now we can't perform a high ground attack. But that's okay, I'm going to use these Nebelwerfers. They should break. Yeah, they completely got wiped out. Then, let's look at the situation in here. This hex, we have 50 intel on this tile. It's fields of snow. Stack value 66, well here is 63, but I guess these stack values don't actually correspond one to one with the power value, which is 63 for this unit. I would actually like to have those anti-air guns shelling, oh, but no, it's quite bad visibility. So maybe no. Let's see if we have artillery. I could try to climb up this hill. Because I don't want to attack. Oh, it's on the same level, so it don't actually matter. That's good. This is 41. 72. We could just tighten this encirclement. I think that could be an appropriate goal. So we could at least like release a couple of units from here. Do I put the HQs? Do I really want to do that and put the HQs here in the Light Forest? Holding that position. And let's see. I'm going to use this unit for probing. I have plenty of artillery, so I can take advantage of the knowledge that we gain. Yeah, they lost 20 men. That's the exchange, equivalent exchange for that gain of recon. We gain indirect fire line of sight bonus if we include this close by unit. They also gain some modifiers, but they can only attack this unit, so I think I'm going to... I don't know, does it really matter when I select these at which order? Is this like the attacking order, that if I put them one by one here in that order they will perform in the combat, or is it all at once? I'm not really sure. But I'm just thinking, because the werfers, if they fire at the same time, and werfers are not really that good of taking entrenchment down. So that's why I'm just thinking maybe artillery first, then separate attack with werfers, and then after that possible infantry attack. But I'm going to do it like this. Okay, we lost actually one of our infantry mortars. We were able to take down their entrenchment a little bit. 12, or no, sorry, 8. Readiness went down. But yeah, they still have a lot of equipment here. I would like to use still more artillery. Because they are now in the wide open. So let's use two more, and then I'm going to do one werfer attack. Yeah, much better. 100 men. Those guns. And I'm going to leave this route open. Like, if they want to go down here, they can try to escape. And then I will be able to shell them down here. So I'm fine with that. Yeah, this is okay. And now I'm going to use the Werfers. We get -6% overstack artillery attack modifier. They've been attacked a lot with artillery, but we just gotta do it one more time. Yeah, that was okay. They are still not close to breaking or anything like that. And these other units, they have a perfect morale. But yeah, I think I'm ready to start moving these units. Where would I need some tank support? Or anti-tank support, actually. Probably just go to the highways. And we have this group of units. They are marked in red because their readiness is only 24. Because they are now marching here. I think those units, to be able to employ them or deploy them properly, we would really need those trucks. They're going to take forever to move to the front. Same thing actually with these, you know. Because they are not all motorized. These guys are motorized, so I don't think they matter. They are going to be that wary of force marching, but still. Let's see. It's 74 readiness. Yeah, it's the leg infantry. If leg infantry has to march, that is bad. Move them one by one. Yeah, we can see that it's this one unit that is not properly motorized. We can see it. This unit has 100% motorization chance. Whereas this one has only 75 carry. Manpower is 90. Well, this is like the difference. This 15 is almost like the difference. Is it always the difference? No, it's not. Carrying this is 136. But it produces 695. Manpower is 75. Yeah, I think this unit has this has way too many Opels. This unit is not capable of transporting other units. Are you sure about that? Because it has so many trucks. 30, and it has only 30 staff. I think I need to actually put those trucks on these guys. Readiness only 75, so it didn't really go down though by marching that much on the highway. Yeah, I need to. This is something that will demand a little bit more research to understand the whole weight and carry details, because it's going to become important further the campaign advances. So according to this, we have a supply issue here, that there might be an enemy unit. That's a little bit of a scary prospect. Nürnberg. I have no idea, is there an enemy unit in here? I would rather use somebody inexperienced. Maybe like these units. Or maybe not the pioneers though. Regular attack? Yeah, I can't do regular attack. Why is it even offering the possibility? I would also like to go up here to see what is in there. There were some units in this forest previously. And I think it's still a relatively high possibility that there are units. 38 recon only. Height is 44. So I think we would need at least 44 recon to be able to even detect anything there. So we don't have that. I'm going to do this. Okay. There was nobody. Stack is 143. Let's check our HQ. HQ should go a little bit down here to give a little bit better bonus. 4-1. How much do they have artillery here? Not at all. It's only anti-tank guns. But they are in good order, so one barrage would be really nice if I would have one unit to spare. I want to see where are those guys on the map. Yeah, they are too far, I don't want to use them. Yeah, I think the Fallschirmjägers. Yeah, but these guys have quite high readiness. I think it needs to be lowered, so yeah. I just don't want to take risks that they can't break through because they don't have enough, they don't have the maximum movement, you know. Yeah, but it's a small unit, so even that one shelling with that one relatively weak artillery unit, it did quite a bit of damage. And also like morale damage, that is really important. So we actually have a breakthrough possibility in here. I'm going to send the pioneers. Yeah, this is the strange bug that I'm just like clicking here. But this doesn't like even show it as a possibility that I would engage. I have to click this enemy unit, press attack, regular attack, attack. Like that. I don't know, there are some of those weird things. And I also noticed that if the game presumes that territory is held by you, because there is now this approximate front line. You can see it on the map. Like this green line. This green line that just goes like over here. But what if I stumbled upon an enemy unit in here with this unit? I went here and I noticed that there is something in there. I took casualties even. But it has happened to me in my like previous runs when I played the Elsenborn scenario that the game didn't like update the front line that there is a unit in here, so I couldn't shell it. I couldn't use ranged attack against it. I couldn't use this, which was really frustrating because I really bumped into an enemy in here, but still it didn't say that I could shell that position. So I think that would be some kind of a bug that wouldn't need to be investigated, because I think that combat or ambush should always trigger because you couldn't enter that hex, that it should really trigger the front line to move so that you can shell that position. That's just my view. That would need to be improved in the game. That doesn't happen really often, but it can happen still. Okay. We didn't take any damage, we just... One unit of us retreated. We took intercept fire in here. These guys shouldn't have a line of sight. But we took intercept fire. Our hide is only 4 in here, so it is possible that we got noticed. I need to now think where I want to move that unit, and do I want to send the Stooks through the same slot? Getting here into the city would be an answer, or going heavy woods. Trying to go to these fields and heavy forest, that's also an option. Yeah. There be an enemy unit in here. Ow. There was. We took 10 casualties. Somehow an enemy unit has been able to lurk behind our lines, basically. That means that I have to do some kind of switching here. What kind of switch could I do? Can I with this pioneer unit? I could probe them, but we are not in a really good position to probe anything. Any ideas? We have to clear this. Going to be a problem for our supplies if we take care of it. Could there be actually even 2 units? How could there be a unit in Vishide and in here? I have a lot of artillery that I can put in there, but I would need more recon for that. Okay, this infantry could move in there. Yeah, we can maybe move it even, because we don't need all the infantry slammed into that small space. Our recon is still just 48. Going to do something like that too. They are now in the open here, but at least they have a potential to maneuver. Or are they needed in here? I have no idea. I think this is the most demanding game maybe thus far that I've been playing in terms of Fog of War. And literally, that's what I call this episode, because this is we are fighting in misty forests, and there's like there's mist everywhere on the ground right now. I was thinking, how well could Panzer artillery do against a direct attack? Because those self-propelled guns again with Americans, they can do fairly well. You know. We have only 48 recon. We could shell it. I think this was a mistake to take the Panzer artillery here, conduct this operation, but how much do we actually have firepower in here? Quite a lot, but our recon is so bad. Do we have any good solutions? Well, this is one solution. We still don't know what the unit is even like. These are mostly just buck guns, they are no use. Yeah. Can't get enough intel. I guess we just need to shell it. No matter what. Those guys can help. Just do a separate attack with these guys first. GI Green. We just don't know. But we gotta shell it. You know. No idea how well did we hit. That's the problem. Yeah, I'm not gonna go uphill. No way. They can be there. They can attack me if they want to. Gonna say to that Hummel that it's, or this Panzer artillery unit, that it's okay. You're free to fire at will. If I were the Americans, I would set up an ambush here. It would be uphill heavy forest. A perfect place for an ambush. What unit should go first? We have 51 recon on this. It should be enough. It's not necessarily enough, but it should be. Yeah, it was. No enemy units in there. So they are contesting the river crossing in here. I would actually do the same. It's even two units contesting it, but they are low. Their entrenchment is pretty bad. We would just need more recon. We need to send units closer. How much do they have anti-tank guns? 8 40mm AA guns. The enemy was smart. They put up a unit in here to prevent our Jagdpanzers. They would need to commit to an uphill battle. Panzers uphill, that's gonna cost a lot of movement. 77. Maybe I just... Or we just sent the Panzers up here. That's perfectly fine for me too. That's just... Let's see, did they do a nasty thing for us that they have a unit in here? I'm honestly scared to do this. If I was the American player, I would put a unit in here. No, there was nothing. How about the other one, Light Forest? Nothing. Okay. Oh, it's even an anti-tank gun unit. That would have been really painful. Really painful. My tanks going uphill trying to charge this position. They could have taken many tanks out. And we don't really have any ranged guns to attack that position. Nope. We don't have enough range. I don't want to overload this dirt road anymore, so I'm just gonna send it through this northern route. I think we have to be smart about maneuvering here. Like, maybe try... This move would be really perfect, but that wouldn't work out if they have another unit in here. So I'm going to scout them first. They might have a unit in here in Mordorscheid. Mordorscheid. That looks very likely place for an ambush because it's a crossing also. I'm going to move the second unit to the same direction so we get double recon. Nothing in there. Okay, there was the unit. Mm, 70 with 20, I think you can't do a frontal assault, so... So we couldn't even attack. Even though that's what I wanted to. I would like these guys to push for an attack. Oh, is it because we have now this own unit in here that this movement cost? Or is it so weak? Why doesn't it exercise zone of control? This unit. Move cost 10. Or is it because of the mist? Is it because of the mist that there is no zone of control now? At least in here. Here is. Here you can see it's exercising zone of control. It means those 10 points. Why don't these guys exercise zone of control? I have no understanding. Is it something about their armaments? But these guys have anti-tank guns. They have also mortars. I get it that these have anti-tank guns, so they can shoot anything around them, but... Is that their combat value is too low? 19 plus 16, that should be high enough. 35, this is 20. 24. But they don't necessarily have enough of those anti-tank guns or something. I don't know. I don't know though. Yeah, I'm a little baffled about this. As much as I would like to use this first SS Panzer Grenadier to go to the flank and attack, but they wouldn't have enough movement. I think it's more important that they scout this forest for us. We don't want any of our heavy guns to get into ambush in this heavy forest, so... As much as I would like these guys to go here and and do the attack. They have 94 points though. They don't have just 20, but they have they don't just have 90, but they have a couple of extra because you can accumulate those. So I have of course these cards. I could give them. Should I give it to him? So then he could attack to the flank of this unit. And we wouldn't have to fight a river crossing battle. Unless we get the intercept fire here, but I think that's actually something that I would like to do. This might seem like such a waste to give unmotorized unit speed. Extra action points for selecting, but gives offensive and defensive penalty. Minus 75 offensive. Ooh. This guy, yeah, I would be able to attack though if I give him. Is this so vital? I think it is kind of vital. It's such a evil trick that they did. So yeah, I'm going to give him speed. This, you may sue me because I made a dumb decision, but I'm going to move it first couple of movements so it can like pay the movement cost first. And now I'm going to give it speed. Just in case that if there is like a hard cap. Yep. Not range to attack, regular attack. Regular attack. We could even go from across the river, but I don't want to. Do just an attack. Okay, we couldn't move them. Let's look at the graphic. One unit held. One is... is it retreating? So I would have actually needed this unit to attack too. Just go through. Yeah, they took massive losses. Capitulated, retreated. But yeah, now you can, yeah. Unit, give me the unit weight stats. So, because they lost those pumas. They are no longer motorized. I'm going to set them as priority for replacements. Yeah. That's the thing that I was like talking about. Still alive. Let's destroy this unit once and for all. Neither of these can move. Do we need any? Their entrenchment is 41 only. They are mostly green. Green unit. I would have artillery if I need to. Where is that Panzer artillery? Or can I use it somewhere else more effectively? Let's just check the Panzer artillery a second map. Where are you? It's here. I think we need it there better, so you have to do without that. I rather use this maybe. And where are you? Oh, you are there. Quite far. I don't think it can even use all of its howitzers. But that's also like a little bit of a waste of a turn. Attack. Those half trucks that are taking most of the damage. Like our soldiers fighting just inside those half trucks, never getting out of them. Yeah, this bazooka team apparently decided to live on, fight on for another day. They are already saying that there is a supply problem in here. How about in Shoppen? Well, this got now all of a sudden problematic. We have to clear out those two units, no matter what. I'm going to use these pioneers. Yeah, from this side. This would be only ranged attack. Just trucks. I'm weird. Self-driving unit. Now these tanks have a free country. I think I'm going to send them here then. Like, yeah, we need Saint Vith, but I can send just the infantry to take it. Authorize the infantry. We need to go as far as we can in the limited time that we have. There is an American unit in here. Okay. We made it in here. Almost safe and sound. So, we are quite close to Vames. What does that mean in a general, in the big picture of things, if we cut off this main road line? We cut off these. We need to also get to Elsenborg to cut these enemy units off. It's an interesting situation, it's developing. I think quite favorably for us. I could even get so close if I want to get from Shoppen a bit forward. Do they have artillery in this section of the front? But okay, let's move the Stuks now here. I'm going to leave this unit for a brief amount of time. In place there. Okay, there's an enemy unit in here. We didn't take any damage. But we need the unit to clear it. So yeah, I was actually thinking to send that. You remember this unit that committed Knittel? I was thinking about moving it here. But yeah, now we are kind of stuck. stuck in this forest. Unless I flank it from behind. So what can I do? Rumbars can get close. We have also some tigers, panthers, sorry. I'm just bouncing back and forth. I need to devise a strategy. I think these hetzers could maybe help with the Saint Vith. I have no idea where their armor is. There more armor in this sector? Hetzers are good against armor. Panzers. They could get to this road. I like this idea too. This is what I do not like. Yeah, let's do something like this. Into the forest. Yeah, stay in the forest here. Just for now. Then, yeah, we will approach Saint Vith from this direction. Mm-hmm. This might be a possible place for a traffic jam here. I think I'm going to concentrate the tanks up here. Yep. Yeah, traffic is getting even worse. Or it's starting to get bad there. How about these hetzers? Could they finalize this unit? Probably not. I don't think they're going to hit anything, but they could do a random shot if they want to. Give it a shot. Just try. One truck retreated. Okay. How about these buckguns as a protection in this tiny village? 37 movement. We have 74. We could even engage with these anti-tank guns. We could have a nice battle. They could hurt our Opel Blitzes though. Give me some info about the carry stats. We have a lot of excess carrying capacity. That's just fine. That's what we need, because we're probably going to lose a lot of those trucks if we don't do any ranged preparation. Well, how will this go if we just burst into them? They don't have artillery, luckily. Luckily, only just anti-tank guns. Mm-hmm. How about what's up with these pioneers? I could send anti-tank guns in here. On the air also. I would like to try to move the pioneers up here. Up on this ridge. I just don't know where the fire came from. I doubt it that there is if they would be smart, they have a unit here, here, blocking these entrances. Because this is fairly smart. Put a unit here, blocking the entrance. Okay. So there was a unit, but it just wasn't in its proper place. Like, why the hell is it here? Why not just here? But of course now it can lure us deeper in the forest and we are stuck there. So I guess in a sense that is also a successful technique. I would like to send the Stooks but I'm just worried that they are going to get shot at. I can always put them here to the pioneer unit. I'm going to do that just in case, you know. Because we don't know, what if there is a anti-tank unit in sets? And you are telling me that we don't have any... Well, we had one of those Werfers, but it was like in a bad spot, so... I think we just have to be marching with all of these guys. Readiness only 12. Yeah. I would like to do this, but is that bad for supply? Everything is bad for supplies if I do any kind of maneuver. But this gets us the furthest, so I guess I'm going to do it. Hansen. Hansen would stick it in there. I'm actually going to put this unit in here, just in case. You never know, you know. What guns can't do anything? It's only those two guns that are doing something. These Fallschirmjäger guns really need to be close to the enemy to be able to do something. Volksartillery. 80. These guys have taken a lot of fire. Oh. I didn't even realize the possibilities. Oh, just use the infantry range tag. Use all the mortars you got. Okay, we took out one truck. Yeah, that's good movement. Yeah, I like this. This is super good. Getting that artillery up there. Of course, I should have moved the infantry first away, but it's okay. What are my options? Should I do some reconnaissance with Stooks? Their visibility is basically zero if I just think about it myself. Like, what can Stooks really see? Okay, we see an enemy there. We have a crossing. We could take the crossing with this unit. These guys taking some intercept fire. It's a tricky situation. I don't like to use tigers. What if I maneuver one of these guys uphill? These guys couldn't even attack, they have only 75 movement. I could scout this position. So what is this? This is just trucks. And two 40mm AA guns. Well, there is these two infantry shielding the tanks, so I can't attack with Hetzers right this turn, so I'm going to use them against this. So rear area men were left alive, but they took out 40mm one truck. And yeah, they actually retreated completely, graphically. Retreated. So now they are ahead of me. I'm going to attack them again. They are destroyed. Okay. Then this infantry we want to shell. And then we want to attack from one, two, three, maybe four directions would be enough. I think four is enough. It's 30. Yeah, the Jagdpanthers, I'm going to rest them a little bit so they can attack. Can do the main attack against these tanks. They have that many, but they excel in destroying tanks. These Brumpars are a little bit of a mystery to me. Are they really like Sturmpanzers? Sturmpanzer. So is this more like more efficient version of a Stuk? More like infantry fighting on it? Not really sure about that. I need to resolve this. I honestly need to go through here. But do I sacrifice this guy's possibility of doing so much damage here by going to this direction? We have 44 recon. Officer cards available. Nothing I can really do. Go cross. And the Nebelwerfers can't even attack. Josef Dietrich can give supervise. Defensive bonus. You can get an extra unit. Gamble. Lead. Offensive bonus. CIC. Well, these verifiers don't even have the range, they only have range against this. Oh, it's only a light forest. Seriously, just a light forest. Well, that's quite perfect for us, I think. Should I be moved like closer? There should be more than this one unit circled. I don't know. Like, of course we could tie up the perimeter, but I think there's a unit. There are units in this. How big of a casualties do we just go in there? These have enough range, okay. These guys only have against this. Oh, I have so many units that they go over the box. Eligible for attack. I guess I will use these. Shell this unit first. Entrenchment went down quite nicely. $250, $250. And I'm going to use the warfare just to weaken this guy. It's a little bit of a waste that we don't use it offensively though. This would also mean that we could take more units out of him. We wouldn't need to tie up so many forces, so okay. Okay, let's do it. Yeah, they lost a lot of equipment there. Okay, and we discovered the second unit. You know where exactly it is. It is here. In the heavy forest. So let's move the infantry. Like that, maybe. Okay. I want to get some recon. I think the pioneers are good because they have these BMWs motorcycles here. So they should have some extra recon points. Recon points is zero. Seriously. Or is it like become points one? We have 54 recon right now. And I'm going to move this unit in here. Okay, a second tank unit appears, but this is a tank destroyer unit. I see. Well, we need pakkans to take out first the tanks and then the tank destroyers. I'm going to shell this first. this kind of a setup. I think 58 recon points they will have to do. I could even do better though, if I want to probe them. I think I do. I'm going to probe them a little bit. I don't know why did they engage them so hard. They just didn't. They didn't need to. Yeah, we did a good barrage. Yeah, it's fairly weakened unit right now. Okay, now we got a 20% positive modifier. Do we want to spare? We have Vakkans, we can protect ourselves to a degree. Some degree at least. Attack. Okay. Let's just see. How on earth am I going to resolve this heavy forest debacle? Will broom bars give me enough? I don't. These pioneers have a lot of movement. I don't want to send those pioneers. Or I don't want to send broom bars alone. How about this Sandic unit? It can't get close enough. How about Piper himself? Piper himself could get close here. Yeah, do it, Piper. We still didn't get enough recon. Hold. No. I'm going to do this kind of move. Give me hex info. We barely know if there is a... That's quite bad. It's not even that necessary to hold this Butkenbach. Yeah, we just need troops down the slot, you know. We have to soften this position, but those are not effective fire. It's not effective fire. Why the hell am I putting any fire in there? Recon 44, hide 44. Where should these guys then go? Like they could get up here even, they could go here. Do they really now have to go back in here? They would have some movement if there is no units ahead. Let's do it. So we got some intercept fire. Concentric attack. We want to put Piper himself in the attack. Where is our HQ for these units? it's in here. Huh. I think I want to move the HQ a little bit closer if I... No, I couldn't get it's this zone. It's on the yellow zone anyways, so... Doesn't matter. I want the tanks to be free. So I'm going to use the Stooks. And Piper. Do it. Was just some weird artillery unit. Two tractors. Doesn't give me any odds. Because the attack wouldn't be successful. Just do something. Yeah, well, at least now the supplies are flowing. At least something. Tigers can now move forward. Weiwerts, I think that would be a perfect place for the Tigers. I'll first go here. Fields. They can hide in Kenbach. That is one option too, but... I mean, the furthest you can go. We'll also set these guys to do economical driving. Driving, you know. Because when you move the combat mode to march mode, they consume less oil. And they can do also better movement because of that less oil usage, you know. Because it's kind of interesting. If you just think about how, if you are like in a combat mode and you're moving, you're maybe moving from one cover to another, you are letting the engines run and so on. But where, if you are not expecting combat, you're just doing marching, you can be more relaxed in the driving. And I think that's exactly so. So let's divide up these forces a little bit. Oh, there's another unit in here. Well, that I didn't really expect. Piper can then go one back. What on earth kind of unit is this? It's in the heavy forest. So... How about in here? How do we want to engage these enemy units? Recon is 43, 70, 73. I go there. Go to Bullingen. 77.5. Yeah, there's a tiny village in there, so I guess we could go there. We want to take the buck guns. Luck and buck. We need to protect the infantry now. Yeah. We can move up here, but then we would need to get the buck guns there too. Right from here, they could take even a shot. But yeah, these guys, their readiness is 51. These guys have only two buck guns, so they are not suitable. They can't protect themselves, that's what I'm saying. How about providing them some flak guns? Yeah, flak guns can reach quite far, but not maybe far enough. Just stay on the highway. Let's consider this. This is height level 1. This is height level 0. We want to basically push the enemy out of this ridge. Because I'm gonna take the units out. So you can see that there is... And I'm gonna take a inspect mode. So you can see that this is height level 1. All of this little bit lighter color. And it's like moving up here to this town of Berg. So if we control this ridge line, we have uphill combat positions against all units that are staged here. And we have like the route is free to Elsenborn if we take Berry. So do we even want to like fight in here? That's also something that I'm thinking about. This is an interesting prospect, I just have no idea what kind of unit we are dealing with. These flak guns would be amazing to get like here. Let me highlight it for you, that would be such a sweet spot. Flak guns in here. They could dominate this position. But the movement of them would be quite difficult. Take forever. Like here. Then if there's an enemy, the infantry unit to cover them. I can still start doing that maneuver if I want to. It's just not going to be easy. And this is just light forest. We could use these pioneers to actually attack from uphill position. Still have very low recon. We know nothing. Now we can do from three sides and attack. I think that's good. Yeah, I think the Jagdpanthers could move a little bit forward, maybe a little bit later. First, we want to take care of this team ward. It's 220 men, so the big unit. Movement cost 0. Is it worth it to send those hetzers? Will those hetzers take out those? And take out stuff. Do they have a lot of anti-tank guns? Two. Sturmpanzer. It could be Sturmpanzer's time to shine. Yeah, like why not? I would rather have an infantry unit though. 77, that's too little movement left. I have the speed card though. I can set that up if I want to. Nebelwerfers. Okay, these guys can't really attack yet. Well, they technically can. 47 is our recon, is that the best we can get? Well, it's only two. But we don't... Do we have a... another of those units that we could send close by? Not really. I don't think it really matters at this point that much. I'm going to commit those broom bars for a tank attack. Oh, we lost one flak gun. And we don't have any movement left, so... Okay. Do we have any more? Four. 7-1 odds. And tell me again, how many anti-tank guns? Two. I don't like that. I don't like that. Take out those goddamn anti-tank guns. There is one of them left still, but I don't think I have the luxury. Luxury of trying to take it. Recon points are pretty even. Pretty even. I don't like that. But I think we have the experience advantage. We should be able to handle this. Yeah, four half trucks again. I have 11 bazookas. I am a bit worried. I could commit these guys. Only for a ranged attack, okay. That's not what I wanted to hear. Do I have any mobile assets left? Not really. Mm-mm. Oh, we revised the composition of this unit, but it should be mostly howitzers. Rear area services. Yeah, but we still couldn't engage them head on. Pioneers could still take quite a bit of damage. 20 movement. No, it's not enough. Yeah. I could perform an attack from upper position here. I'm just doing some easy moves because all of these seem kind of difficult. Yeah, I should have used this Kraus unit to take out this infantry once and for all. Now we would have to use Hetzers, and they have ton of those bazookas, so I'm scared. I am scared about that. But I would really... Okay, well, this is just a ranged attack. It's better than nothing. Oh, I guess, but then they will entrench. They will entrench if I do it. And they have only three rounds of fire available. Eight into one, but we don't really know if we should probe. Let's use these guys and do a basic probe. Okay, it's 21. 21. So we can actually take them out like this. And then they would hopefully retreat here to the open. Yeah, I think I could be fine with that. Line of retreat. This is also a light forest, just a light forest style. It's a bit interesting. Because it basically provides us an opportunity. This is height level 1. Okay, so they managed to retreat to a higher level. Yeah, okay. Well, I'm fine with that. No fire expected, but it's misty, so... So yeah, these are just to be used defensively here. Armored cars. Okay, and these units now need pack-guns over here. To protect themselves. I don't think we want to shell these units though. We rather this if we want to shell something. We have the Panzer artillery here. 224. 226. I'm not that sure what kind of damage can we do with standard Panzer artillery. I think I want to do I would rather have the Tigers maybe engaging in here. Destroying this Elsenborn situation, that is our priority. 95. Yeah, it is 16. Okay. Okay. 2-1. Yeah, they can counter-attack with those tanks, or... I mean, counter-battery fire. I think we want to do one against Ward, and then we want to do another... Maybe. But this is an empty unit now. We don't have to worry about it anymore. What about these Nebelwerfers? What kind of damage can they do against these tanks? My position is still that Nebelwerfers are better against soft targets. Or can it be considered what they basically wreck these tanks? I want to know. And I think you want to know too, so I'm going to do a combined effort of Nebelwerfers. No, apparently if I put them together it just doesn't work well. That's why I'm going to do separate attacks, so first one just a test with an artillery. Or we use it for this unit, this is maybe more important. Can we? We can't. Can you probe? Is this movement cost 116? 115, yes it is. That's a huge movement cost. I am going to encircle these units now completely. Okay, but there was that residued unit in here. Luckily nobody got hurt. But that's good to know. Yeah, getting forward in here is more important. But also clearing this pocket is, that would be like nice. But is it like time sensitive? That's what I'm like thinking. And the headquarters hold their own if they get attacked. Heavy for. Do I have an artillery barrage to spare against these? Against these units. Yeah, I said that I. But I would need to probe this unit first. I can just try to probe. It's a horrifyingly bad position where this is, but. They could still probe it. So we would get the recon that we need for an efficient artillery barrage. And use this artillery to engage with them. Probe. Very costly. And they have a really, really strong unit there. Also really bad probe because they had to cross that river and all that kind of stuff. Not really, really suitable. Yeah, let's just get their entrenchment down a little bit. Yeah, this would almost need a tank unit to break this position. We also need to break this position. Okay. And we need to clear this pocket. Do like a massive amount of damage. How about we take that. Okay. Fourth one, we could attack with the headquarter unit. I would rather have them here in the open, but they are of course blocking now the supply route. Partially, they are still, these units are still getting supplies though. You can see it from the green dot. And this is kind of very difficult to maneuver. I thought it would be easier. So yeah, 81 to maneuver there, or we just cross in here. We need more warfare, more everything here to break this deadlock. I think that just had to be done. Would we push them out from here, from the forest? Let's try it. Yes. Now they are fully surrounded. use the headquarter unit to attack, engage in combat. Or they now battle hardened staff officers. Yeah, this raid would be over already. Just now it would be just a matter of starving them out. How do I want to starve them? We would need to take these guys out. They have such a high readiness, they are a pain in the butt in that respect. We have so low recon. So low recon of the enemy units. Now the enemy has gotten close here, they might be trying to breach our lines even. I think these guys can now go in here. It's a light forest style. And these guys are without supplies. We need to re-establish the connection, so... I think they can just attack. Thank you. And yeah, now we have like a decent recon. They can't do a probe if they... we don't know, is there an enemy unit here? Probably not, but this is a higher level. Let's see. No enemy unit. Goodness. We get that high ground for those units. Okay, let's look at the officer cards. We can get that extra recon if we want. I want it before this unit. It's more important for this unit. Okay. That's interesting. How about like a regular attack? Do we get some nice bonuses with this? We get some like could be useful. Oh, there's a unit in the field. And these have a massive entrenchment, 187 entrenchment. Team Walker. Okay, maybe shelling them is not that good of an idea. I just thought that they could do a lot of damage, but shelling that highly entrenched unit is probably worth it. Then I would say that we need to sell this. Do this first and then the warfare. Look at that. Such a good barrage. And then do the warfare. Okay. Now we are talking. And commit all of them. We lost one Jagdpanzer and one Wirbelwind. And some of them survived magically. And we have to do a river crossing. River crossing to position of heavy forest. Ay. Even though it's just 60 men, but still. How the hell do we get across now? They have zero entrenchment right now. They have 12 bazookas. Can those bazookas penetrate our Panzer Force? These have side plates though. How about if we use some infantry support? Do some warfare attacks. Sixteen readiness. 41 movement cost. Like I could send this guy to help with the artillery here. They will entrench if I shoot them. Forty-one moment cost. Fifty-three. Yeah. Okay. I'm going to move it here. Let's get rid of these units once and for all. 27. Yeah, we would actually be able to fight with more units. Yeah. Okay, we get that bonus. Yeah, I think we should take this in. 8-1. 20% modifier. This would be 50% modifier, but we would lose the same ground position. Our attack goes up quite significantly though. I think we might want to take it. It don't matter to me, it's only that one unit that is suffered. It's coming, the attack is now coming from so many sides, so do it. Okay, graphic capitulated. They fought till the 8th round. Really to the last bitter end. Okay, that pocket of resistance has been taken care of. Let's try to make a river crossing. Oof. Looks so bad. Looks really bad. You have to remember that their readiness is super low. So I'm going to all out attack. We try to push them the hell out of there. This might be really ugly, but they haven't been entrenched, and we can push them out. Do I have a guard chance? I would have an attack. No, Just speed, hold, okay.
Nothing.
What? We couldn't break through. And that was super costly. Oof, oof, oof. The readiness was 13 at the beginning of the combat, and there was other units in the tile probably, or no, I don't know. We completely misestimated their strength. So yeah, that ended up in disaster. I think there was another unit on the other side. Not just those guys. Yeah. Well, what on earth do we know now? Do we take the Panthers out here to engage with the enemy tanks? I think we kind of have to. Well. I should have just accepted the fact that there is no way across here. Except if we use pioneers and create a bridge over here to this hex. Sneakishly. I think that's our way. That has to be the way. Yeah. But live and learn. Moment cost 8. Yeah, whatever. That was such a demoralizing defeat there. Yeah. They played their hand quite well. I thought that there was only that one. Yeah, that's the interesting aspect of the game, that the fog of war is so brutal. How about here? 6-1 odds. I don't know, I'm just scared. Only 12%, it's like one headset against this 40 men with all of those bazookas. That's also super bad. Then, no thank you. I'm going to say that I've taken enough risks right now. And they all didn't pay off, so... How about the Tigers? Should I be more aggressive with the Tigers? I guess I should. Would we get to Nidrum? Probably not. These are marshes, we can't even properly set up shop in here. So I think we should move to any direction. I guess it would be nice, but we would get shelled, we would get attacked. We would have to entrench. This guy doesn't have any entrenchment cards. Try to go to Nidrum. Okay, he managed. And we got a better recon in what is happening in here. It's mostly trucks in that unit. Oopas ogas. Couple of mortars though. These have 5 bazookas. Okay. Okay. These guys are in the plains. I'm going to shell them for that mistake. I'm also going to test their entrenchment. They are heavily entrenched. So it's only 66 anymore. Yeah, but it's still too high. I probe these guys first to get a better picture. I think I can do a small probe. Than 70 men lost for the enemy. Plains, fields of snow. I think I want to concentrate on attacking here, but I would also want the tanks to engage, but I can't. It's just not possible. 63, 34. We can actually attack from a high ground position. This is also a good place to attack. So I'm trying to attack in all of those positions. Okay, 8-1. I guess we could make this an artillery duel. Give me these guys to select. Back. I would like these guys. Okay, these guys can attack. Attack. Okay, that was a good fight. Pretty okay hits. Back. Okay, we managed to win. They panicked. The other one retreated. Cool. So they have been now withdrawing over here. I can move 48. Leave this defensive position. I think I should. Okay. I took them all out. It's excellent. Then we have this position. Fill it first. But not with this. I can use this first. Over here. Let's do something like that. Also super useful. Super successful artillery barrage there. This is not going to be that successful. Going to be a bit difficult. Difficult, let's see. Well, 12-1. I could even take these guys out and engage. Double attack. About these Hetzers. First do some more barrage. More barraging there. Very minor effects. Let's try this out. I'm going to take this infantry. Twelfth one, okay. Those guys are not even needed then. Do it. Yeah, we lost a lot of stuff in that attack. Yep. They lost 120 men, we lost like 60. 90. Three stooks. Yeah, they somehow managed to fight really hard. And they retreated where is an enemy unit already, so I'm not going to risk it. But these Stooks could now go uphill. This is at level 2. That's the problem, that's at level 2. I think I want to do kind of movement that they go like around here into these forts so we can be envelop the enemy or something. Okay, there's an enemy position in here. So we took quite high losses in the previous turn. This makes me a little bit more worried about this attack. And these enemies are highly entrenched. But I have faith in us. I have faith in this. So let's see. Yeah, that was a clear battle. Clear victory. I don't know, were they like so veteran or senior units that they were so difficult to take out? Maybe. Okay, I'm going to leave it like that. I'm not going to move it. How about here? There is an engineer unit in here, entrenched. To a degree. Effect in entrenchment, or nothing really. Okay, there's a tank unit behind. That's good to know. Seventeen to 1. Well, I think we can take them out. They retreated. Go back to the fort. Okay. That looks all fine. We need these Dukes and the Buck guns and some infantry so we could take out these tanks. And these are only light tanks. Scots, Greyhounds. And yeah, Greyhounds are just armored cars, so. Yeah, this is the entrenched unit. So these are now free to move. Okay. Well, where should we go now? There was an ambush. Okay, there was still one unit in here. I forgot about that. Yeah, these guys lost all of their readiness, their morale probably like bottom low. I want them to be a priority. I want them back in combat strength. They have to be replaced, those losses. Such a risky maneuver that I did. It just wasn't worth it. Wasn't worth it in the end. This looks all fine. Okay. All fine. Something like that. Let's see if there are some units that I haven't moved. I want to flip the turn and be done with this. I think there were a couple of big mistakes from my side. And yeah, definitely this blunder in here. I don't know about this infantry unit to get them somehow ready for combat. These guys could maybe need help here. They might get pushed if they attack from these two sides. What is it, the city position? Yeah, it is. So let's do that. I'm going to do that to this guy. I'm going to give them a hold order if that is necessary, but because I need to hold this river crossing, so I'm going to say that to a stubborn defense, hold order, play card. These guys are now going to defend. These AA guns could be shelling from here. I like that idea. Let's go forward. This guy can move. some economical drive. Here we need help. We need help here too. Maybe this is the best road. Could lower their readiness already right now, but the barrage would be only partial and I wouldn't have any units to exploit that, so maybe no. How close are we to Bastogne? Well, fairly close. Fairly close, I would say. Nothing in here to be done. Oh, here. This looks rather fine to me. Maybe protect these with possible enemy counterattack. What kind of equipment do you have? You have pack-guns, Panzers. It's just that the... How many do you have left? 2 Scots, 6 Stuarts. Stuart is a light tank. Word is a light tank. Well, this looks good in paper, but what's the reality? They are going to fight till the end, I think. Our pack-guns can take some of them out, mortars not really. They don't luckily have any Shermans left, but still like more than 10 tanks against only 3 pack-guns. So maybe no. Maybe I say no this time. But then we might end up fighting against them in this high ground crossing. So that's also really bad. It's all bad options. I think they have to... Max combat for... 4 rounds, reconnaissance in 4 hit points plus 60, attack minus 50. Okay. We lost 20 men. They lost 10. So I guess we can say that we weakened the force a bit, but I'm happy with that. I'm going to move it over here. I'm going to move the pioneers ahead. Oops, could even get this close. I'll take it. Hitzers are here to block movement. They're gonna go zone of control. Here we have just guns. Okay. Oh yeah, and this situation here with these anti-tank guns. Four to one odds. Don't really like that. I think we want to go to this high ground. We can stay here. We don't have to get close to the city necessarily. Tigers. We could even technically send them here if we to take Malmedy. Or we can engage across the river in the next turn. I don't know. It's a difficult decision. They could move a long way to the west. Save lot. I think I will send them westward. This will resolve itself. Maybe one more. Insert some control to this. Maybe also here. Then. Okay, we got the knowledge. This is how it serves. So it's that artillery that we were afraid of. Relative terms. Okay. Everything okay here? Yeah. Good to me. Some protection for these guys though. going to do this kind of move. To move the buck gun in here and this guy here. Oh, it's protected. Artillery unit. This unit just has to be chilling here. I don't think there is a way for it to go forward. Show me this on map. Yeah, it's okay, it was just this. Yeah, we are good. I'm going to press the turn to flip after I move this unit. Yep. Okay, let's do it. Next turn. Oh yeah, after this. After this unit. Just do it. Okay, we got an attack. They lost intercept fire. Okay, Team Robbins. Cavalry squadron. Okay, they attack there. Accidentally. Bad recon. They just moved their artillery away, they didn't engage us. Yeah, they are pushing our units. The tank division there. I have to inspect that. That was big losses for three units. Yeah, where was the tank attack? That was really brutal looking. Was it in the south? Those 60. Where the hell was that tank attack? They are shelling. Ooh. What is happening? They are bombarding this unit. We took quite a bit of damage there. Okay, they are sending more reinforcements against my push towards Bastogne. Yeah, this wasn't the prettiest turn. They actually gained some couple of victories. Tank counterattacks against our infantry units. That just got shredded. Missed. How much did we lose this turn? Yeah, we went almost double. 2,800. 16,000 for the enemy. Okay. Let's go and check this situation out. First history, let's open those major battles. So this is Eschweiler. This is towards Bastogne. Okay. This was a good placement of our unit. How about here? Yeah, they went with tractors and howitzers pumped into our... like, we had the pioneer here taking care of the river crossing and they pumped into us. Here. So where is this? Oh, this is east of Bullingen. So the unit in the forest was actually a panzer unit, a tank unit. So they pushed our infantry that did the attack from the other side. Then we lost 180 infantry there. They lost only small losses. And then they did a secondary attack, we lost even more infantry. Here they bumped into our recon units. They got trapped. Attack against headquarter unit. Attack against our panzer artillery. Artillery fire. Damage done to lock 357. Lock destroyed. Location destroyed, is it? Yeah, they shelled us from somewhere because they had knowledge of our positions. And we lost 110 men in that shelling. That was super effective artillery charge. Barrage. And then they tried to attack us. So, was that all? I think so. That was all. Mm-hmm. Earth is happening here. There's a tank battle opportunity. Sent the Tigers against Shermans. Jagdpanzers, they can not join the battle, sadly. Okay. So they are trying to relocate their armor. They pulled back their units here. Happening here in the north. In the north they shortened the line here, I see. Tanks are still within this unit. These are veteran soldiers, so the veterans would help them. But now they went again to this plains hex, which I'm going to again attack from possible sides and destroy the unit. Going to do the same routine over and over again. Here, anti-tank unit engineers. We lost vision. It kind of says that we would have open access to the river crossing, but I don't really know about that. Where is that unit that got pushed? I think it is this unit. Unit detail. Yeah, it's missing 460 infantry. It lost a lot of infantry in those battles. Because this is just motorized infantry. It doesn't have any hard units. It's not a... It's a Panzer Grenadier regiment. So yeah. It is a support unit for Panzer, basically. Yeah, we are next to Saint Vith. There was a bombardment here. But yeah, we could take these guys out, these priests. Stuks versus priests. And this cavalry squadron took some mortar fire. They got stuck here. We could just use Jagdpanthers and... If we want to spare the Panthers, we could just attack with Jagdpanzers and block guns. Use those 88mm guns. How about here? Well, we know that in Guvi there is an enemy unit. This can go on support. So quite urban, so it might be problematic. One of other option is that we just push forward to feel some. And this was that unfortunate artillery unit that pumped into our engineers, destroyed itself. In Hoffeld, we knew there was an enemy we pumped into accidentally. I think we should just try to make attack from maybe two sides or just one side. Strong push. And apparently the enemy has withdrawn from here. Here they still okay. They blew out both bridges in here. All those engineer units. Well, I have my own engineer. It will be fixing that bridge. No time. I'm going to move in here. I can't attack from either side. So I will really need those bridges up, running. Yeah, I would like to have it in here. Bridge, I think it. Let's see. Cards. New bridge. X with an assured ownership. Okay, we lost 5 half trucks. There was an enemy unit hiding in here. So we have to first push that enemy unit. This is getting quite intense. But yeah, that's the requirement if to succeed in my plan. Get those troops over. Yeah, because we can't be stuck in here. We have to get everybody across as fast as possible. Yeah, but I will have to investigate. How would I, what would be the best way to do it. Our recon is 62 already, but we still don't know. Still don't know what is in here. But after we know, we can then commit troops for an attack. This pathway, there are enemy troops in here, but they are just hiding. I think also similar, they are just hiding in here. I don't think they abandoned the city. We just have to approach it carefully. Okay, now the enemy tanks are moving away. They are falling back. These guys took a massive amount of artillery fire. I was too ambitious. I should have just put them in here. No, we think that the lines would be over here. I think there is enemies in this forest, so we think that this is just an encircled unit. Cool. Okay. Not all hope is lost, but we definitely took more damage than I would have liked to see us losing troops, so couple of bigger upsets, but nothing major. I think we still have a chances for victory. I hope that the timetable isn't completely ruined. And yeah, it's just gonna get harder and harder from this onwards. But yeah, I thank everybody for watching the stream. Next time we are going to start pushing, maybe from north to south this time, just to mix things up a little bit. But yeah, thank you. Bye.